Joining us now for his thoughts on the law as passed is Maguindanao 2nd District Representative Toto Mangudadato. The congressman also previously served as Maguindanao governor. Good morning, Congressman.
Good morning, Attorney Mike.
Thank you for joining us. First off, for many of us who are hearing this for the first time, why split Maguindanao into two and why now?
It's time to split this province, the Maguindanao. Kasi so lucky naman at sapat na rin ang ekonomiya. At yung mga social services kasi, Mike, ay hindi nararating kagad-agad, pero kailangan mas mabilis pa ang social services at iba pang mga serbisyo na maiparating sa mga constituents natin. So that's why we decided, and the constituents decided to split this into two provinces.
Congressman, I remember in 2006, the ARMM Regional Assembly created the province of Sharif Kabunsuan. But in 2008, the Supreme Court struck it down, saying only Congress can create a legislative district and by extension, a province, because every province must have a legislative district. So in a way, does the passage of this law serve the purpose of that 2006 move of creating the province of Sharif Kabunsuan?
Kasi hindi yun na nga, Mike, no? Hindi nga dumaan doon sa tamang proseso. And it was the member of the assembly who made a decision and passed their own bill, no? So kailangan talagang dadaan muna sa Kongreso bago may sa batas, no? At kailangan pagbutuhan maayos ito.
The local government code sets three criteria for the creation or conversion of a local government unit. That's income, population, land area. Were these three criteria met, sir?
Yes naman, Mike. Ano, sa populasyon, walang question doon. Sobra-sobra pa nga eh. More than 1.7 million yung aming populasyon dito sa province na Maguindanao. And talking of economic, it reads up to the required doon sa total land area eh. Alam naman natin, isa sa pinakamalaking area ang Maguindanao province. So wala hong question doon sa nasabing mga requirements sa criteria.
In short, sir, walang madedehado. Yung Maguindanao del Norte at Maguindanao del Sur can sustain themselves separately.
Yes, Mike. That is the complete kailangan maayos at pumasa sa mga requirements.
All right. Now, Congressman, one of the goals you mentioned in your explanatory note in sponsoring the House bill on this is the need to bring public services closer to the people. But at the same time, you will be duplicating the existing government, meaning you're creating two sets of government officials. Wouldn't the funds that will be spent on bureaucracy be better off spent for public services? What do you think, Congressman?
Alam naman kasi, Mike, ano, Attorney Mike, ano, ito namang ating pagsiservisyo sa tao ay talagang open naman, ano? At alam naman ng bawat ahensya na lalong-lalo na sa ngayon ay talagang kailangan natin na mailatag lahat para po sa mga kababayan po natin.
Now, you also mentioned, Congressman, in your explanatory note that Maguindanao is one of the poorest provinces in the country. How will subdividing Maguindanao address this? What are the guarantees that the two Maguindanao provinces will truly benefit the poor?
Dapat lang, Mike, na maiparating ka agad-agad. At alam naman natin na ang budget doon sa internal revenue allotment natin plus other collections natin ay sapat naman dito sa mga constituents natin para maiparating yung services natin.
Mm-hmm. So if hinati na ho ito, Congressman, dalawa na yung provinces, madadagdagan ba yung IRA na maibibigay sa Maguindanao in general?
Remember, Mike, meron tayong yung Mandanas law, no, na yung ibang mga ng gobyerno ay maiano na sa mayambag na sa local government, ano. So mas lalong lalaki at mas lalong gaganda yung mga services natin plus the collections of the locals, ano, na maidagdag do sa internal revenue allotment.
Mm-hmm. Now, Congressman, will subdividing Maguindanao prevent election-related violence like what happened to your wife and to several journalists in Maguindanao massacre in 2009? Is that part of the consideration?
Since I assume as governor, Mike, no, yung impunity ay medyo talagang naiwasan, no? at itinagbawal na rin yung mga pagdala ng baril. So hanggang ngayon na sustain yun, Attorney Mike, ano, na dapat hindi na mangyari yung gruesome na nangyari noong 2009. At ito nga dapat iniiwasan ng bawat mga politicians to sa amin na hindi na dapat mangyari yan.
And Congressman, how will you address concerns that the creation of a new Maguindanao province could just be a political move to benefit politicians or local political clans?
Hindi naman doon, Attorney Mike. Para po sa mga kababayan natin at para mapabilis lalo yung mga services natin sa constituents natin.
All right, Congressman Maguindanao, thank you for joining us this morning and thank you for your insights. Good luck on the two new provinces in Maguindanao.
Thank you, Attorney Mike.